table, please raise it at this time. Now take a look around you. This is a visual representation of food security throughout the Chicagoland area. As a team from the South Side of Chicago, this is a statistic that we're trying to change. My name is Maddie.
I'm Jennifer.
I'm Jake.
I'm the oldest.
I'm Andrew.
I'm Dane.
I'm Jeanette.
Ariel, if you please turn your attention to the screen.
The kinds of vegetables that are healthy for them. Being able to see them grow from beginning to end, being able to harvest them themselves, being able to just taste the fruits of their labors, because they're going to participate in this. I believe that this is going to change their thinking about the way they eat, change their thinking about their work ethic. I truly believe that these students are really going to feel a change in themselves.
Team CHASpen, and our project's name is Operation Farm to School. Now, we chose Kim and Andrea's challenge because as an agricultural high school, we feel the need to share our knowledge of urban agriculture and healthy living with students in an underprivileged community.
Over 500,000 citizens living in Chicago live in the food desert, meaning they do not have access to a grocery store within 2 miles of their homes. Of the 500,000, 400,000 of those citizens live in the African-American community, similar to the one I grew up in.
Our goal was to implement a garden in a food desert. The first step we took was to create a request for proposal to release to CPS schools. Then we would select the target school community. To make this project possible, we would solicit business and community donations. Then we could begin planning the garden build-out and conduct a student interaction day.
We first began our project with creating a request for proposal. Here is an example of the request for proposal that was sent out to 35 elementary schools. We made our decision based on the school's immediate needs as well as their ability to sustain the garden. Through this documentation, my team ended up choosing Ralph Metcalf Elementary School.
After weeks of planning and meeting with school officials, we finally set the foundation for the garden up at Metcalf. Then students engaged in an ag discovery day where they went through 5 rotating workshops ranging from how to plant and cultivate crops to turning those vegetables into delicious and nutritious foods. Then we handed out pre and post surveys to measure our success.
These are just some of the questions we ask students, and as you can tell from the responses, it's very difficult for them to obtain fresh vegetables in their community. One child only got fresh vegetables when his grandparents traveled to Indiana. The results of the post survey were overwhelmingly positive, so we believe that our project was a complete success.
As you can see, there are two print media outlets, Beverly Review and DNA Info, that has over 50,000 person reach, along with WGN's Orion Samuelson. This week alone, we reached over 2,000 people on Facebook.
Now, through this project, we have made multiple partnerships that will allow us to continue to build gardens for years to come. Metcalf's community, their school, their students, their teachers, they're all extremely committed and dedicated to continuing their garden and maintaining it throughout the rest of the year. Now myself as a freshman, Leotis as a sophomore, and Jenny as a junior are all extremely dedicated to continuing this project for the rest of our time at Chicago Ag's. By the year 2019, we plan to have implemented 8 gardens into CPS schools.
This is just the beginning.
Thank you.
You knew that you were in the food desert? So you're going to support them and what they're doing for sure?
Yes.
Questions from the judges?
What was the hardest thing you all had to do to pull this project off?
I think the hardest thing that we had to, the hardest challenge that we had to overcome is the beautiful weather that we have here in Chicago. It definitely was difficult to kind of combat with the weather because we wanted to plant on a day that was reasonable for, you know, the students because we wanted them to enjoy this project. We didn't want them to be, you know, out complaining that they were cold. So I think the climate was definitely the biggest challenge that we had to overcome.
Can you tell us about the strengths that each of you brought to the work and how you all worked as a team to make this happen?
I think when we went to the Aspen Institute, there was actually in the beginning where we weren't really familiar with each other before becoming an Aspen team. So we went through the preliminary stuff and we found in each other's strengths and weaknesses and areas we were strong at. For example, Ariel's excellent at social media, while Jeanette was excellent at teaching the students. So we kind of played off of each other's strengths to achieve our common goal.
Do you have plans to link up with Northside on the compost project? Have you been networking at the rates?
Northside, if you're ready for us, we're ready for you.
Any other questions from the judges? All right, let's give them a